together. Help me welcome to the stage your host for this evening, Shannon Norman.
I'm Shannon Norman, your host. Yeah, I'm 35 and I wear overalls all the time now, 3 days in a row. Thanks for noticing. Hell yes. This is, I have Hacksaw Jim Duggan's body. I might as well have his clothes now. So, whoa! It's all I know about wrestling. All right. We got a great show for you tonight. We got two of my favorite comics are on tour. They're on the Whiskey Gun Tour. They're Hunter Roberts and Jeff Blank. Woo! And also have two local favorites, Ocean Dwyer and Suzanne Lawrence. Woo! Excellent. Gender-neutral bathrooms are over there. Woo! Pinball's in the lobby. Woo! Please don't play pinball during the show. Anybody here drinking?
Yeah!
Good. That's good. Hey, 2016 was a sad year, right? What was the saddest part about it? That David Bowie died, or I spent all of 2016 working on a Cartman impression? This is all I got.
Hey guys.
That's it. Hold here. I'm in our ventriloquism this year. Wonder if I can combine Bowie and Cartman. Let me try.
There's a stutter, man.
No, I can't. It's terrible. 2016, I'm like, yeah, this is the year I'm gonna nail fucking Cartman. Started 2017 on a bad note with a Facebook fight. Got into a Facebook fight with, a one-sided fight. My ex-fiance called me out on Facebook because she was like, hey, when we had sex, Shannon used to eat my ass. Yeah, that's right. Yep, she threw me under the butt. Right? She's like, he ate my ass. I'm like, lady, I also ate a rotisserie chicken out of a Shop and Save dumpster once. So you're not really entering the upper echelons of taste and sophistication. Especially when you date the human raccoon. Thank you very much. You guys hear about this Trump?
No!
Hey, I don't want to cause any fights here, but that guy's a real macadamia nut, am I right? Huh? Anyway. Hey, you know what? I got a hot take on Lady Ghostbusters. Let's talk about it now. Lady Ghostbusters, a lot of people were mad about it when it came out. They're like, you're ruining a classic movie. First off, you're not using the word classic, right? Secondly, I thought it was great. Did anyone here see it? Cool, all of us who saw it in theaters are here tonight. Good. I thought it was great. I think they should remake more movies with all female cast. You can start with the movies in my web browser. Huh? Thank you. That joke is called Topple the Patriarchy. P.S. I'm gay. Thank you. The tag on that joke is something I truly believe in plus toppling the patriarchy. Jump it, everybody. Good. All right. Yeah. So, when the first day I bought these overalls, I was like, wow, I look like a Trump vote come to life, so. You guys heard about this guy? This guy's a real hazelnut, right? By that I mean he's gonna sit in America's colon for a couple years. Yeah. Hey, in case you're keeping a running tally, my 11th cousin committed suicide this year.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. Not 11 of them since January 1st. I mean, over the past few years, the 11th one did it, January 2nd. Yeah. Yeah, run. Some families, when they come over from the old country, they bring like a meatball recipe or a way to make wine. The Normans, when they came over as a barnacle on a boat, brought a fucking sweet ass noose recipe, apparently. Unbeatable so far. So many family members have committed suicide that we refer to self-checkout stations as birthright kiosks at this point. I don't want to get too political here, but I'm going to draw a line in the sand right now, okay? We're going to separate the wheat from the chaff, if we can. Stephen King? That guy's a hack. Yeah, you don't believe me? Huh? Here, I'll give you an example. He wrote a book called Pet Sematary, okay? And in the book Pet Sematary, anything that you want, you bury in the Pet Sematary, will come back, but it ain't the same, okay? His 5-year-old son, Gage, gets hit by an 18-wheeler. You know what happens when you hit a 5-year-old with an 18-wheeler? Same thing that happened when, for her 90th birthday, you were like, hey, as a gag gift, let's hit grandma with an 18-wheeler. With your cousin who smokes too much weed, you're like, he's probably going to kill himself one day. And you get together, you get an 18-wheeler, and you hit her with it, and she turns into dust, a tooth, and some hard candy. Well, a 5-year-old just turns, it's like that, he just turns into a pop of red mist and the soon-forgotten memory of buying little shoes. There's not enough left of a 5-year-old if you hit him with an 18-wheeler to scoop him up with the snow shovel from the garage, put him in a casket, take him up to the pet cemetery, and have him come back and terrorize old Fred Gwynn in the film. Now I get it, Stephen King's got to pad the book a little bit. Because the only other thing that gets buried in the pet cemetery is a cat. And when some people paid $6.95 for this book in paperback, so he's got to pad it. Because otherwise, that book would have been a pamphlet called My Cat is a Fucking Asshole, Whether He's Alive or Dead. You know what? This has been a lot of fun. I'm going to keep this show rolling because I'm so excited to get people up here. Are you ready for your next comedian? Fantastic. Your next comedian coming to the stage. She's the head writer of Pit Tonight. Very funny. Give it up for Ocean Dwyer.
College kids have too much time on our hands. That's what Pit Tonight is. I'm just going to let you guys know in the front row, I'm going to pretend that I'm not afraid of you, but I am very afraid of you. This close is like my third base. This is as far as I've ever got with anyone. No, I know that I have too much confidence for a woman who recently recovered from an adult eye infection. Only to get another adult eye infection the next day. Yeah. I looked it up. Adults aren't supposed to get eye infections. We're supposed to be clean enough. That story, thank you, women D. No, I know that I think I might be very, very dumb, and no one's surprised. I know I sound like high strawberry shortcake all the time, but I think my brain is also high strawberry shortcake. It's fun up there though, it's like cupcakes and puppies. I figured it out when I was tricked not once but 4 separate times into going upstairs at the same party because they told me there was an aquarium there. You guys ever been to a frat party? No angelfish and sharks. Just one guy. He's got a tank with a snail in it. It's like, fool me one time, like that's not cool, but like fool me 4 separate times, respect. Lifelong friends. Gonna get a Christmas card from that man one day. I'm not from Pittsburgh originally. I grew up in rural Vermont. Woo! You guys have actually been there?
Yeah.
So sorry. Yeah, that's where I lived for 18 years. It's like if everything was icy and white. all the time. But in Vermont, we don't call things the right things. We call water fountains bubblers. Yeah, and soft serve ice cream creamies. Yeah, that's a gross word. But it did make me very popular my freshman year of college when I moved here. I was like, oh my gosh, Pittsburgh is so hot. Do you guys want to get creamies? And I lived in a mostly male dorm, so I had a lot of fans. They're like, yeah, we do. Definitely lady wearing flannel and Birkenstocks. Here. They're like, well, normally unless the ladies are special, they give them away for free. I'm like, oh my gosh, guys, the big city is so nice. They're like $2 at the general store back home. So they figured me out fast. I didn't give anyone else creamies, my friend. I was with that aquarium man. I went home recently for Christmas break, and I got to hang out with my little brother. He's a year and a half younger than me, and he has very severe dyslexia. I don't know if you guys know dyslexia. It's when you jim jamble all the words up in your brain. And he is really fucking cool because of it. He went to sign up for his sophomore dorm at college this year, and now he's in Australia. And for some reason, my family loves him more because of it. He was like, yeah, I know it was an accident, but I'm going to go on study abroad. And I was like, wow, Jack's so cool. He's so confident. And then his dream was to go to Austria. He just wanted to drink beer all semester, but he clicked the wrong box. Yeah, you know, and instead of going back, he was just like, yeah, snakes, tank tops, I'm doing it. Everyone's so impressed by him. And I was like, well, sometimes I do stand-up comedy in Pittsburgh. And they're like, you do that on purpose. This was an accident. You do that because you're sad inside. You forgot the part where I like attention from strangers, family. Got them. I do love my family, but I do think that my parents are trying to reverse Menendez brothersly. Yeah. What is that, people that don't live inside my brain? So you guys know regular Menendez. We all love scary killers. A regular Menendez is where a child kills their parents for their parents' money. And a reverse Menendez brothers is when my parents kill themselves and give me all of their debt. See me, and I know you guys know I don't read social cues very well. I've apologized to many Talbot's mannequins in my life. I like librarians. But I did finally crack the case. I spent a lot of time with my parents in high school. That's how I did it. I cracked the case because my dad calls me, and he says, hey, I got a new hobby. I'm making duck prosciutto in the cellar in wintertime in Vermont. I don't know if you guys know, it gets like negative 10 degrees, you know? And to make duck prosciutto, you take a tiny wet duck breast and you pack it with salt and juniper berries.
No!
And you tie a tiny noose and you put the duck breast there and you just let it sit.
What does that
mean? Do? That's you got to the punchline? And my dad calls me, and then I tell him that maybe he's practicing tying tiny nooses to tie an adult-sized noose. And then I get taken out. Like that. problem with serial killers. Like, I did move here to a city with a lot of bridges, and I did think that people would warn me about being chopped up more. You know, I was lonely in high school. No one invited me to the maple syrup festival. That's a lot of Law and Order SVU. And I know I don't look like a Barbie doll in a nurse costume, but I like a bleach smell. One dentist chair in a basement with one drain. I can hang. Tie me to your radiator, I'll stay there forever. No, I am trying to be a better lady in 2017. I'm trying so hard. But by accident, on the day of the Women's March, I did buy a man breakfast and then immediately after wash his feet. Yeah, I was trying so hard for like a month. It's fine though, because I did only blow him 78% of the way. I took away all his reproductive rights. So the ladies won. I have the wrong idea of feminism. Like, my idea of feminism is we're gal pals and we're hanging out together. I think that's what girls do. But we also are trying so hard to buy cocaine because we're fun and we like to have fun. But we are buying it from a female stripper. But she does really like her job. She works somewhere cool and she wears organic body glitter. And we're all very safe. And we are all wearing pajamas together. Is that feminism? I don't know why they won't give me my minor in gender studies. I do go to Pitt. All I'm getting is a minor in mining engineering, and they recently told me that that's not a thing anymore. No, I just think I was born in the wrong era. Like, I would have thrived as a late 1950s housewife. Like, yes, I do have like a typing degree, but like, I could throw that in the trash. I want to stay at home in an apron and bake. I want to wait for my husband to come home every day and make him a glass of clear liquors because I want him to die first. You know? Yeah, honey, I made you this ham and jello. That's what you like, right? All day I just want to sit and eat lead paint off the windowsill and nap in the sun like a cat. And make a quilt for President Eisenhower. As I said before, if you do tie me to a radiator, I will probably stay. I'm going to have to end up throwing my engineering degree in the trash because I don't know how electricity works. It's the moral of that joke. I don't know, I can't see many of you people. But I'm technically a young person, and I've been told that I'm supposed to sext. Yeah. Is that a thing? You guys sext?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I believe it. And the fact that I'm not going to make eye contact. No, like people, guys take that, they're like, send me a picture of your body. Like, you guys got the internet, right? You know Kate Upton's breasts are real? You're like, fine, describe your body to me like a modern Hemingway. Yes, that's how college men I talk to talk. Well, just imagine if where a normal woman had breasts, there was two tiny raccoon skulls jutting out of my body. Do you like that, sir? Talk to you soon. No, I haven't heard from him since. The best relationship I ever had. No, if you guys can't believe it, I live in Oakland and I was catcalled the other day. Oh, yeah, one believer. That's I I was catcalled, and I've been catcalled before, but it's when I was working in Station Square and I had to walk down the Smithfield Street Bridge every day, and it was outside Adult Mart, and the man did eat cigarettes. But he did like my body a lot. You know, this time was a lot better. I was walking by, and like the guy didn't do the normal catcall kind of thing, where you just yell at a lady, I'm assuming. He did the sound when you refresh Twitter on your phone. Kind of like, beep boop. I like attention, and I don't have any other hobbies, so let's think about this for days on end. Okay, we're in Oakland. What's near Oakland? Carnegie Mellon. What does Carnegie Mellon make? Robots. Yeah, I think I may have been the first woman to be catcalled by a cyborg, guys. That means that cyborgs like women with fingerling potato bodies. No, I am only 21, but I know that I need to kind of like clean up my act. I need to decide what I want in a partner. Because I have already seen too many weird wieners in basements. Yeah, I feel like a lot of ladies know what I'm talking about. It's like, this is a futon next to a water heater, and it's Tuesday, and that's a 90-degree angle. No more 90-degree angle dicks. I think I nailed down what I really want in a partner. I just want to date like a vaguely Jewish, with like a little hair, hands, and that's it. Only the hand part. And like in no sexual way anyway. I don't know if you guys can tell, I don't want that. But like a hand doesn't have feelings. I don't have feelings either, I don't care about that. A hand doesn't tell you that you drink too much on a Sunday morning. And a hand's not a little bitch, so. Also, hands cannot legally be called Greg. That joke's called Fuck You, Greg. That's all I have for you guys tonight. Thanks so much.
Next comic coming to the stage, she asked me to prepare this statement. Just tell them whatever, Shannon, I don't give a fuck. So, without further ado, Suzanne Lawrence!
I'll just say no, I'm not her mom. Don't tell her that. can I start out by telling you guys about some bullshit that happened to me tonight?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fun, right? Yeah, so I was at Eden Park, and that's not the worst. I was in the bathroom, and this woman came up to me when I was washing my hands, and she goes, I just want you to know that I am totally comfortable with you being in here. I was like, yay, thanks. And then I got home and I was like, I wonder what that lady, oh my God. So I painted my nails. That was probably it. Is everybody okay? While we're on the subject of things I'm not pregnant. I'm just fat in kind of a dumb way. It's kind of the best way to be fat, though, because strangers will come up to you and congratulate you. I mean, yeah. They'll ask you sometimes if you picked out a name for your fag. And at least once a week, someone comes up to me and they're like, when are you due? And that would never happen to someone who's like normally fat, right? You would never be like, so when are you getting diabetes? And the worst part was actually that when I did actually get pregnant, the only way you could tell was that I quit drinking so much. I love being pregnant. I know that's like a weird thing to say. But here's the thing, is that when you're pregnant, you can be a huge bitch. And everyone still thinks you're adorable. Like, there was this office party I went to, and I don't know how much cake I had. but it was at least 4 pieces. I had most of the cake. And no one said a word. And you know, if I hadn't been pregnant, someone would have been like, hey, slow down, or, you don't work here. Remember, I was walking to work one day, I was pregnant, and I dropped something, and I tried to bend down and pick it up, but I couldn't get down there, it was just too big. And 3 separate strangers stopped and went, aww. And I'm like, if you think I'm so damn cute, why don't you pick up my cigarette? That's enough about me. I want to find out about you guys. By show of applause, who here is a dog person? Okay, who's a cat person? Who likes plain old human sex?
Yeah!
You can't change your mind. You don't get to clap twice. You made your decision. No, after we had a kid, our relationship with our dog changed, which is really sadder than we thought it would be, you know, like we used to go on runs together, like go to the dog park all the time, like, but we had a birthday party for the dog, you know, like, I know, dog birthdays are dumb, but they don't know it's their birthday. They have no idea why you're getting them so drunk. No. This is how insecure I am. I put on makeup to go pick out a dog at an animal shelter. He eats tampons out of the trash. But I thought dark circles might be a deal breaker. We had to get a dog, get the baby, and then we had to get a bigger car, so we became everything we hate. And you know, it's actually fine, it's cool, but the color of this car that we ended up buying is called Urban Pewter. Urban Pewter. That's kind of like a brownish silver. So I guess the guys at Honda were just like, well, we can't call it brown pewter. That's another word for brown. The red SUV, the Trailblazer of Tears? There is nothing urban about a Honda CR-V. A Honda CR-V's natural habitat is a Trader Joe's parking lot. I don't get PMS, I just have 1 week out of every month where I'm really into HGTV. Like, I don't want to eat chocolate, I don't want to watch sad movies. I just want to see people be dicks about closets. And they do it every time. Like, every time they open a closet door and it's some, like, massive walk-in closet, they always make someone, usually the wife, say, this is big enough for my clothes, but where are you going to put yours? Let me tell you where he's going to put his clothes. He's going to put them in the trunk of his car. When he finally gets tired of your, I want an open concept, bullshit. And moves to Arizona with that yoga teacher he's fucking. That's what he's gonna put. The other thing I love is that when there's a house and there's no dishwasher, they always make her say, "I already have a dishwasher.
It's me."
And then the husband does the saddest little... And that's my favorite moment, because if you look really closely, you can see just this existential terror just like bubbling underneath that tucked-in plaid shirt. But my favorite HGTV show, if you really wanted to like lean into some nihilism, is House Hunters International. That should be on the History Channel. Because that is a show about white people acting like they discovered places where brown people already live. That is all that show. No, I was going to some like open air like produce stand. They're like picking up fruit and stuff and acting like it's so exotic, but it's like a fucking mango. Are you even gay? I don't know what to believe anymore. I'm trying to learn Spanish.
Hola.
I originally started to do it because I wanted to travel more, but now I'm just doing it to piss off Trump supporters. Like, I have this fantasy where I, you know...
What?
Do you want me to make a call? Can someone in the bathroom?
Okay,
thanks. Should I call? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep, it's behind the curtain. Wow, okay. That's baldy, I'll give it. No, but I have this fantasy that I'll be in a restaurant and there'll be like a Latino family or something, and some asshole redneck will be like, "You need to go back where you came from," and I can make them feel comfortable by speaking Spanish to them. I mean, the only thing I know how to say so far is "Yo quiero un gato," which is you know, "I don't want a cat." But I feel like my message will be heard. No quiero un gato. It'll be fine. Yes, I actually have one other Spanish phrase. Because I feel like I'll use it a lot. Let me try it. Perdón, he comido algo que, en retrospectiva, era puramente decorativo. ¿Dónde está el hospital? And so it translates to, "Excuse me, I have eaten something that in retrospect is purely decorative." Like OSHA, I also get a lot of pink eye. Weird, we both had a pink eye joke. Yeah, I got a lot of pink eye. I don't know why. Like, I'm a clean person. I take a lot of showers. I wash my hands all the time. I go to the bathroom. I wipe from front to back to face. Sometimes I tell people I got cum in my eye, just so they think I'm like the good kind of dirty, and not like the fish concert kind. I'm from West Virginia. Anyone else here? Woo! I need to step the line to punch it in there. That's all over it. That's what you get for answering rhetorical questions. A lot of comics talk about depression, but no one talks about the good things it does. And sometimes I'll wake up in the morning and I'll make a big long list of all the things I need to get done that day, and depression just comes along and crosses the whole thing out. It just writes, "Storage Wars." Which, by the way, is the ultimate show about people being dicks about closets. No, I don't know if I'm actually qualified to make jokes about depression. No, I'm not. I'm not like I'm going to kill myself depressed. I'm just buying underwear at CVS depressed. Like, first name same basis with everyone that works at Little Caesars, depressed. That's actually true. Yeah. I went in there the other day, and the guy behind the counter was like, "You're having a tough week." Like, I don't need to take that from a 30-year-old with a Juggalo neck tattoo. Jackson with an X. But what I really said was, "Can I have 3 extra garlic butter, Jackson?" No, I really am from West Virginia, and I love my home state, but shit has gotten weirder, it's gotten weirder. Like, people in my hometown, they love 3 things. They love colds, they love racism, and they love Donald Trump. Hold on, that's 2 things. That's just 2 things, I'm sorry. I used to make jokes about Republicans and call Republicans stupid on stage, but I can't even do it anymore because it just feels too real and sad. It's like when you were a kid and you thought it was okay to call your best friend's little sister retarded as a joke, but then it turns out that she's actually dead. Worse than you thought. I went home recently. My mom wanted me to go to Walmart with her. I know you guys think you've been to Walmart. But if you say you've been to Walmart, but you haven't been to Walmart in West Virginia, that's like saying you went to Burning Man. And you just like took a flight on Southwest. Anyway, I went to Walmart with her, and I'm just gonna say this. If you're vaping inside a McDonald's, inside a Walmart, that's a turducken of white trash. Worse is that Walmart was somehow inside another Walmart. And then that Walmart was inside a Big Lot. Thank you guys. My name is Jenny Moore.
Time to kick off the first barrel of the Whiskey Gun Comedy Tour. Are you ready? Yeah! All right, this comic coming to the stage is filming a web series called Forever Alone. Give it up for Hunter Roberts!
Yeah! Now they asked me what song. Give it up for Shannon, everybody, by the way. A song I wanted to come out to, and I was like, "Hey, you know that song from the animated Transformers movie?" And Shannon was like, "I gotcha." So that's why I came out to Stan Bush's The Touch. Look it up. You'll be happy you did. Hey, so I was recently vaping in a McDonald's and a Walmart, and saw this girl with pink eye, and No, look, man, hey, y'all, I'm happy to be here. We did a show here a few months ago, and it was a fucking blast, and, like, that was awesome, and, like, I'm in a, like, super good mood. This tour's been going great, and good job, and, you could need those, but, like, I've been, like, really happy lately, and I understand it's a weird thing for a comic to say out loud, but, like, but, like, I've been in a good mood, and that's super strange. Here's why, mainly because I got a girl's phone number the other night. Big deal, because that shit hadn't happened since the third Bourne movie was in theaters. It's been a bit. But, I'm the worst, so I didn't do anything with it. I just got, like, a framed cocktail napkin on the wall. Kiss it every night before I go to bed. But that's more numbers than I do. I'm fucking adorable. I'm super cute. Actually, I'm not one of those people. Look, I'm not one of those people that thinks that they look like something. Like, I've seen myself in a mirror before. Like, I know what this all looks like. I get that. You know what I'm saying? No, I don't need your pity. I don't need your, like, I get it. I understand what this is. You know what I'm saying? Like, I've basically spent the last third of my life treating my body like a rental tuxedo that I paid the insurance on. Like, am I losing a button? Pow! Fuck it! Like, I have the same basic diet as a raccoon, y'all. Like, the only difference between me and the raccoon is that the raccoon is nice enough to wash his hands before he eats. I don't do that. I'm unhygienic. That's true. Look that shit up on Spotify right after you look up my song. I don't know. Like, it is a drastic change. I used to be somebody. I used to be in shape, right? Like, I used to be captain of the football team. I understand I don't look like captain of anything now, except maybe Crunch. Shit. But it's so drastic. I used to have, like, abs and, like, luxurious hair. That's all gone. It's so drastic almost that, like, It's like I pissed off a gypsy at some point that, like, tried to come to my house seeking shelter from a storm, but, like, I turned her away and she got really pissed off, so she cursed me to look like this, and I was supposed to find love before all the petals fell off of the flower. But, like, instead of doing that, I just memorized the main event of every single WrestleMania, and now I'm fucking stuck like this, and I'm like, goddamn furniture talks. That joke is dumb. Because I don't have furniture. What do I look like? The 1%? I shop with a basket because I can't afford enough food to fill a cart. That got a little too real. That hurt in here.
What did this shirt mean?
Do what? Oh, this shirt? I'll tell you a story. This shirt actually saved my life. But anybody... this is a real story. We're going to get real, though. Okay, so I was in... This is a shirt. Did anybody watch that 90s show on Nickelodeon called All That?
Yeah! Yeah.
This is a repairman shirt. Anybody know? I was at Comic-Con and I did this thing with the Nickelodeon booth and they gave me a bunch of free shit, so I got this shirt and I was wearing it to a show in Cincinnati. And I didn't mean to tell the story at all, but we're doing it. So I was wearing, I'm not from Cincinnati and I was there by myself, and so I stopped to get gas, and apparently I stopped in a bad part of the town, and I didn't know that. And so it was one of the ones where, like, you can't go into the gas station. Like, there's a whole gas station there, but you can't go into it because it was after a certain hour. So you have to, like, pay through the window. But I didn't know that when I walked out. So I walked out, and I was the only white person there. So I walked up, and I went to go in the door, and then somebody behind me went, "Nah, white boy, that ain't how this works." And, like, I'm immediately horrified. I just, like, stand in line, and, like, everybody in front of me is paying, and that dude that said that was standing right behind. So this is what the back of the shirt says. Like, it says that. So he saw my shirt, and he's just standing right behind me, and I'm just real terrified. And he goes, "Oh, man, that shirt good as hell." And I quote, "That nigga ain't prepared shit." Oh, thank God, and All That shirt saved my life. Kind of like I always knew that it would, probably. I turned around, I was like, "You're right, he didn't," and then I paid my money and got my gas and got the fuck out of there. I was like, "I don't have any Legends of the Hidden Temple shirts." That's a lie, I have three. Fuck it, I'll tell that joke. Hey, who here remembers the TV show Legends of the Hidden Temple? Yeah. I remember that show. That show was good as shit. If you don't remember that show, it was a 90s game show that came on a Nickelodeon network. It was like, okay, so you had to find like an ancient artifact that was hidden in an Aztec temple in the middle of Orlando, Florida. I don't know. But like, what they would do is they would pair up a bunch of kids, a bunch of tweens, and they would battle against each other in like these tests of physical prowess to determine who was. It was basically the Hunger Games with water socks. That's what Legends of the Temple was. But like, so like they would compete with each other. There was a bunch of teams. There was the Blue Barracudas. Everybody loved Blue Barracudas. The Red Jaguars. And that's my team. I was the Silver Snakes. That was my jam. And then there was like the Purple Parakeets, the Green Monkeys. Yeah. And then there was this team called the Orange Iguanas. And if you like the Orange Iguanas, then you can suck a dick, okay? Like, if you like the Orange Iguanas, I bet you'd just fucking love to be in House Hufflepuff, wouldn't you? You fucking losers! Losers! You're all losers! My Slytherin House Cups say otherwise, you fucking losers! So calm down. So you would eliminate the other kids, which I assume has killed them, and so then you would get to go into the temple, right, to find that missing artifact. You get to go, like, find, like, Benjamin Franklin's lost kite. I don't know. Like, don't ask me how Benjamin Franklin's lost kite got into a jungle, like a temple in the middle of the jungle in the middle of Orlando in the first place. But sure enough, there it is, tacked up on the wall. So, like, you would have to go into the temple to find this thing. When you went into the temple, you would go, and each room had, like, a trick to get to the next room, right? Like, you go, and there's one, you'd, like, sit down in a specific chair or something, and the door would open, and you'd, like, pull a certain book or something. And then there was this room. Okay, wait, hold on, sorry. You did all this stuff because of the prize. Ooh, the prize. It was always a trip to space camp. Because there's no other reason to go to Alabama that has ever fucking existed. Space camp. That's what's there in the temple in the form of Amelia Earhart's goggle. So you go in and there's all those rooms. But then there's this room. Yes. But then there's this room. Alabama sucks. I'm sorry. I've been there. It's like the land that time forgot. That's the land that civil rights forgot. So there's this room, right, that I like to call the place where your childhood dreams of going to space camp went to die. And that room was called the Shrine of the Silver Monkey. Oh yeah, fuck that place. Like, that place ruined more childhoods than divorce. So the trick to the Shrine of the Silver Monkey is that you had to assemble a silver monkey statue. Came in three pieces. Came in a base, a middle, and a head. So the kid would run in there, and he's like, where's the base? You're looking around, you're trying to find the base. You're like, over there's the base. You grab the base, you put the base on the pedestal. You're like, where's the middle? Oh, it's way up on the fucking wall, because that's fair to do to a 13-year-old. So the kid's like, scaling a wall, and they grab the middle, and they put the middle, and they're like, where's the head? I can't find the head. And then all of a sudden, a temple guard pops out and grabs this child and molests him on national television as he pulls him back into his rape den. And hold up, where the fuck was that job on career day? Where the fuck was temple guard? Right? You got a doctor, you got a lawyer, you got a teacher, temple guard. What the fuck are the requirements to even be a temple guard, right? For 30 minutes. Can you do these three things? I sure can. Well, then go forth and give children nightmares. Right then. So your kids, your partner is just getting fucked on national television. So then you have to run in there and save the day. So you finally run in and you make it to the shrine of the super monkey. You're like, oh shit, where's the head? There's the head. You grab the head and you're putting the head on the statue. And you're like winging around and the fucking statue's like not clicking in. The door's not open. And you don't understand what's fucking happening. And I'm sitting in the house just going, God damn it, just put the fucking monkey head on the side of the statue. Do this for me. For me, God damn it. Because I need a win. I need a fucking good to happen in my life. I'm sitting in the middle of fucking landlocked Tennessee. I'm never gonna get to go to Orlando. I'm never gonna get to go to the Hidden Temple. I'm never gonna get to fucking train where the astronauts train. So goddamn it, you stupid fucking iguana, do this for me! And he's fucking banging the thing in and the fucking crowds count down. They're like, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You see the fucking fear of God coming into this fest and this kid as the fucking buzzer goes off, because then he knows he's never gonna get to go to space camp. And then I see the goddamn Legends of the Hidden Temple death march back down to the front. He fucking walks by another temple guard with like a rum and coke and a half-lit cigarette. He's like, I let you play with my silver monkey. And he just starts fucking crying and repressing memories immediately. And it's just like, fuck, you finally get back out there to your fucking teammate who just balled up, clammed up, needs therapy for the rest of his fucking life. And the fucking host is, oh, this motherfucking host. This fucking gingery Kirk Cameron looking motherfucker with goddamn rolled up shorty shirt, khaki shorts, a fucking denim shirt, and a fanny pack? Are you goddamn kidding me? A fanny pack? If I was going on an expedition deep into the Amazon and a ginger with a fanny pack was my god, I'd just go ahead and inject malaria into my own dick hole. Don't you fuck off, I'm not doing that. So you get back out there, your teammates just having a fucking existential crisis, and the host is like, oh yes, cheer for these fucking failures, loud studio audience. Yes, everyone at home, millions of you, laugh at because they could not assemble a fucking statue. Meanwhile, one of those purple faggots from Guts is holding up a piece of the aggro crack. Like, I climbed a paper mache mountain and you couldn't put together a monkey statue? Bitch. And the fucking host is like, yeah, now cry. Cry, you little pieces of shit. Cry, because your tears sustain my shitty, gingery being. Or at least that's how I remember the show. It's 2017, so that means I gotta use dating apps. That's just the world we live in now. It just did. Anybody in here use Tinder? Room full of liars. Goddamn liars. I was like, this is a safe space. I just opened up to you all. Well, for those of you that don't know, Tinder's an app on your phone. It shows a picture of... So it's just a picture of a person, and that picture pops up, and you get to choose yes or no whether or not you want to fuck that person. That's its only purpose, right? And then now people are putting like Bible verses and shit on there. And I'm like, that's not where that goes, Karen. But like, it's just a picture and you choose yes or no whether or not you want to have sex with that person. Which kind of proves definitively that beggars can in fact be choosers. That's my one Tinder joke, so I'm going to need a Comedy Central special right the fuck now. I like how my stool's starting to look like the set from the movie Signs. collecting cups. No, I also use OkCupid and fuck that place to death. OkCupid's pretty much the elephant graveyard from the from Lion King, right? That's where the shadow touches. You don't ever go there, Simba. Don't ever go. Here's why I fuck that place to death. Here's why I fuck that place. Because it's Cupid, y'all. It's Cupid. He is the Roman god of passionate love. Passionate love, right? He's an archer, shoots you with an arrow. You get struck with that arrow. The first person you see after having been struck with that arrow, you fall madly, deeply, and passionately in love with. Passionately in love with. That's awesome. That's what love should be. It should be passionate. And then some dickhead on the internet tacked the word okay in front of that. What? Ah, damn it. But like, fuck, like, no, you shouldn't. So I'm gonna start my own dating website and call it Fuck It, That'll Do, Cherub. Oh well. Like, right? Like, it should be passionate. It should be passionate. Like, that's what it should be. Like, you see the person that you love, and it should, like, you should get butterflies in your stomach every time. Like, that's fucking amazing. You know what I'm saying? Like, that should be awesome, right? We shouldn't want mediocrity with our love. We shouldn't want okay. We should want something great, right? We should want something better than, like, well, she got the same ingredients on her pizza as I do, so I guess I'll spend the rest of my goddamn life with her. You better not have watched episodes of Mad Men without me. There's another thing I see on dating websites all the time. It says if you have bad grammar, don't even bother sending me a message. Couple things. One. You misspelled message. So I don't know how fucking high your horseshoe be. I don't know, maybe she just really likes back rubs. That's the smartest joke you're gonna get out of me. Number one fear when you go on a blind date from the internet? This is the question and answer portion of the show. Anybody number one fear blind date from the internet?
Serial killer.
Bing! There it is! Serial killer. That should be everyone's number one fear. I asked that question in Huntsville, Alabama one time, and some dude in the front row was like, does she doesn't look like her profile picture? I was like, what fucking charmed existence do you live, Kyle? Worst thing that can happen to you on a blind date is an Uggo. No, serial killer. Like, no, this isn't fucking Family Feud, 100 people turned away, top 6 names on the board. No, it's one person, one answer, bing, serial killer. Congratulations, you get to go to the Showcase Showdown. And I realize that that's actually The Price is Right and not the Family Feud, but I digress. Serial killer. Lot about serial killers because I don't watch A&E all day. But if there's a cross-section of people that probably have perfect fucking grammar, it's the guy that's got the mummified corpse of his mother sitting in bed next to him. And he can't go to bed every night until he brushes her hair. But it's not her hair. No, it's a hair of a wig. It's a wig with the hair of all the women that made the mistake of swiping right before on Tinder. That's the guy that's got a serious problem that you don't know the difference between there, and there, and your and your. Right? The guy's gonna cut your fingertips off and knock your teeth out to make your body harder to identify is the guy that's like, oh, you use it with an apostrophe when you meant to use it without an apostrophe. So what I'm saying is, like, date people with bad grammar. Like, a little bit of bad grammar. Don't date stupid people because stupid people are awful and don't deserve love. But it's like a little little bit of background, right? Like, they might spell glamour with an E-R, but they're not going to cut your face off and wear it about town. That's my dating hack for y'all. Shit, I did a set that I wasn't expecting. Where am I at on time? Huh?
4 minutes.
4 minutes, sweet. I did say that I was... What the hell?
94.
No one cares about the Deathly Hallows.
We don't get a Bible versus a dumbass.
Okay, never mind. World Cup versus Deathly Hallows.
Why you?
Talk to me after the show. We'll talk about it then. I promise you we will. I love talking about my tattoos. Talk to me after the show. We totally talk about my tattoos. But real quick, I told you earlier that I was in a happy mood, but that's not partially all the way true. I'm also in like a really weird emotional state, if you couldn't tell. Here's why. Because I saw a movie recently and fucked my shit up. I'm sure you guys have seen it. It's Disney Pixar's Inside Out. Yeah, a couple of y'all seen that fucking nightmare? That fucking... Oh man, that fucked my shit up bad. I was not prepared for that sort of anarchy. Like, that was evil. Fucking evil. Like, it was a super emotional movie. Before one of you dicks are like, well, it was a movie about emotions. I fucking knew that going in, y'all. What I didn't know is that I was gonna cry like a bitch in a dark room surrounded by children and somebody's fucking imaginary friend poofed away into non-existence. And I realized I probably should have prefaced that with spoiler alert. But spoiler alert, Pixar movies are fucking sad, y'all. Like every goddamn one of them. You remember Finding Nemo? Finding Nemo, that beautiful, colorful movie with all the hilarious talking fish? Remember that movie where in the first 10 minutes, a stranger comes along and murders a guy's wife and all of his unborn children, leaving him as a single father to raise his one disabled son? He wasn't prepared for that sort of responsibility. He thought he was going to have a wife that was going to be there with him to help him raise this kid. So what's he do? Of course, he becomes super overprotective and just hunkers down on this kid. And what's the kid do? Of course, he just rebels and swims off the deep end to go and try to touch the butt. And then he gets kidnapped by some Australian orthodontist as some sort of fucking sacrifice to his shitty goddamn niece. What the fuck, Darla? What the fuck, Darla? Stop giving Darla fish. Darla kills so many fish that the fish have a name for her. She is Darla, shaker of bags, killer of fish. Bringer of death. And like, they are fish, y'all. They're fish. They have short memories, but they remember this brace face little cunt. What the fuck, Darla? What the fuck? Where the fuck are your fucking parents, Darla? You stop giving Darla. You kill so many. Oh, God damn. Killing small animals is the behavior of a serial killer. That and perfect fucking grammar. And then there's Up, where in the first 10 minutes the guy actually gets to get married because a barracuda doesn't eat his wife. But JK, it's a Pixar movie, so nobody gets to be happy. Because he finds out he can't have kids, and he finds out he can't have a wife because she goddamn dies of cancer. And then in Toy Story 3, all the toys you love as a kid literally almost burn in hell. What the fuck cartoon devil works in Pixar that makes me fucking ugly cry watching a fucking movie surrounded by twins? I goddamn Claire Danes cried the other day watching Finding Dory. Goddamn it!
Thank you.
is from Knoxville, Tennessee. He taught me that you can put cheesecake bites in a milkshake. He also won Shannon Norman's Most Kissable Comedian 2015 and 2017. Give it up for Jeff Blank!
Goddamn right that's conga. Everybody wants to hear conga, they just don't know it till they hear it. Hey everybody! Man, give it up for the dude from Dig Dug. All right. That was cool, man. All right. And give it up for my buddy Hunter, man. Don't you love that song? He's all right, man. I like that guy. That's the only dude I'll go on a row with, man. He's all right. And I want to point out that shirt thing that he, because you asked about his shirt. He has. I've never heard him tell that on stage, but I've heard it about 30 fucking times. That's all right, man. Last New Year's, I saw him kick a sparkle in a girl's face by accident. You can YouTube it, and it's fucking great. In fact, I invite you to YouTube it, download the video, and then put music to it, please. I want to change his life. They asked me what music I wanted, and I was like, comedy. And I fucking love comedy. Like, a lot. Like, I feel like pouring my Miami sound machine. Like, there's it out there somewhere. Like, every Thanksgiving, they leave an empty spot at the table. Just waiting on Gloria Estefan to show up. Like Elijah and shit. I feel like the Miami sound machine talks about Gloria Estefan the way those kids in Thunderdome talk about Cat Walker. They all thought it was funny, y'all. Google that shit, I get it. Man, it's cool, man. I was gonna ask for applause for who boned in the bathroom, but I think they left.
Round two.
All right, who's boning in a bathroom that ain't an Applebee's? Fucking get your shit together. You're a fucking public fucking fern bar. Get it together. There's nothing like fucking 12 feet from snow skis on a wall. That makes you feel good. I think that's a me thing. All right. This is cool already. I do like this place. I've been here a couple of times. I don't know if anybody's ever seen me when I got here. I hope you haven't, because I got a couple of jokes I already told before. But I fucking love Pittsburgh, man. You guys are cool, man. Yins are cool. I'm from Tennessee. We say Ewins. Y'all say Yins?
Y'all.
Where are you at?
Y'all.
It's the same thing. It's just like, we. Siri, who the fuck does this bitch think she is? Home. Do y'all know what that is?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the house of the fucking future, y'all. It's amazing. And then my buddy texted me, he's like, man, the history from you and Hunter and staying in my house is weird. Like, why were y'all arguing over playing Special Lady at the Waffle House versus Walk the Dinosaur? And why did you ask Google Home who farted? I spent all day fucking his Instagram. I was like, hey, Google Home, who invented spaghetti? And it told me, and the follow-up question was, hey, Google Home, who the fuck does spaghetti think it is? I just wanted to make his day at work better, man. I think I did. Now, this is a cool town, though. I like this town. This is cool. I was walking down the street earlier and I saw some dude walking at me and he had no eyebrows, right? Cool town, man. I don't think it was a genetic condition. He started getting a little 5 o'clock shadow. I think he did that on purpose. Don't maul him, man. Fuck that. He made that choice. He was like, man, I could just be in Kroger and nobody care. But he was like, I'd like to fuck some people's day up. Hey, anybody here, if you want to start crazy people out, go ahead and shave them eyebrows off. See what happens. All that creepier than one dude walking at you with shaved off eyebrows, group of dudes with shaved off eyebrows. Because them dudes got an agenda. And it ain't fucking hugs. I saw a dude wearing a shirt that I was so happy about. It just said, don't let my big dick scare you away from a really nice guy. Pittsburgh's all right, man. Not all heroes wear capes. And this is a nice place too. I'm not used to being in a nice comedy theater and shit. And give it up for Arcade too.
Arcade!
You guys are fortunate to have this, man. I know a lot of towns, and not a lot of towns have something like this. This is really cool, man. This is really cool. And people that run it are really nice people too. But this is really cool. I like this place. This is all classy and shit. Y'all got lots. Not just Christmas lights hanging on the wall. Or like my old roommate called them fucking lights. This is cool, man. I'm used to being in shitty dive bars, like dog bars. I love fucking dog bars. And I don't mean a bar where they're just like, you can bring your dog in and it's all cool. You guys are good. Hat. You guys look like a modern telling of Rosencrantz and Guildenstern. I want to point out how smart this crowd is. You guys are fucking cool. The rest of the set's going to be Seeger Ross jokes, alright? Oh, you got it wrong. Oh, we never get to say that in Knoxville. I'd be like, man, y'all like Hank Williams? Nah, this place is cool, man. I'm alright, y'all. I do love Pittsburgh, but I gotta give you a. You guys gotta step up your bathroom graffiti, man. Get in the gang, come on. Somebody else, Marco, you yell polo, man. Fucking write it on the wall. Get it together. I love bathroom graffiti. It's one of my favorite forms of art, but my favorite part of it is the secondary bathroom graffiti. Yeah. Like somebody wrote some and somebody else was like, I also got a sharp people fucking smart than me. Amazing. And nonstop, I've seen some of the best I've ever seen in my life. One of my favorites, right? It was written over a trough. Also, ladies, did you know that we have to pee in troughs? I get that y'all had a women's march and shit, but we have to pee where horses eat. And we ain't happy about it. It smells awful, we're rubbing. Anyway. I saw this beautiful, beautiful poem over a trough, and it was it seems like a weird place to put it. I'm supposed to engrave that in granite. No, chalk it up on plywood over a trough. Now, somebody wrote, we're all victims of our own accord. Some die by the pen, others the sword. Some find the devil, others the Lord. But we are all victims of our own accord. Right?
And then right under it, somebody wrote, "But I drive a Civic." Sometimes. You thought you were a badass, turns out not so much. So I like a secondary bathroom fade. I did see one in Chattanooga, it didn't have any follow-up, but it was beautiful. Somebody wrote on the wall, "Your mama got snakeskin teeth."
That's T-E-E-F. Fucking teeth.
Now, I don't know what that means. I feel like either one, it means your mother has poor oral hygiene. That's unfortunate. It's an insult. It's meant for a stranger. Or it means your mother was so rich. That she got their bitches Captain Cobra. That's amazing. Way to go, Karen. You worked it out. But my fucking favorite one I've ever seen in my life, right? Somebody wrote on purpose on the wall.
Y'all read
it? Yeah.
Yeah. I like cocks deep in my ass. And then right under somebody wrote, "And getting caught in the rain." Your life get better, but it happened that day for me.
Man, you guys are fucking cool. All right, man.
I'm from the South, clearly. But I was here today, and I was at a gas station. I heard a dude. I realized that the South kind of creeps up north. Turns out y'all got rednecks too. We say yuns, y'all say yins.
Yeah.
Yins. Oh, yins. Yeah. Yins. It sounds cuter when y'all say it. We say it, it sounds like a hate crime. Like, if you were in an alley and someone was like, "What are yuns doing?" Like, "I was hanging out." If you heard, "What are yuns doing?" Rapidly that way. Why are you wearing a flipped up black flag hat and fucking overalls? That's a Shannon joke, sorry. Shannon looks like a rapist. Anyway. We'll make that happen. Everything's gonna be cool. No, I was at a gas station. It turns out y'all got rednecks that have like migrated north. I don't know, it's cold. Maybe they came up here. But it seems like that's backwards, but they're rednecks. They're still rednecks. Let's go north. Maybe it's warmer up there. I got football teams. Come on, man. But I heard a dude tell another dude, ask another dude at a gas station, he's like, "Hey, man. Is Randy still doing the drugs?" Alright. Now, here's the first thing. I don't know if y'all know a Randy. Round of applause. Anybody know somebody named Randy? Woo! You already know why that question is fucking stupid. Here's a few things you can assume about Randy. First of all, real good at drywall. What he does, man. It's okay. It's a genuine profession. His DNA used to be a double helix. Now it's a fucking dream catcher. That's awesome. That's Randy, man. Right? House full of pewter dragons. That's awesome. Secondly, here's the thing you're going to say about Randy. This is a few times in his life.
he's yelled this:
only two people on this earth can judge me, and that is Jesus Christ and Ric Flair himself.
No, he said that. Woo!
And I'm pretty sure you ain't the Son of God. And I am damn sure you ain't the finest athlete what has ever graced the squared circle. Woo!
And that was at Thanksgiving. At least three times a day, a Randy will say this:
this is fucking bullshit, dude.
She's in there. You know what the one thing that you can assume about a Randy is? Still doing fucking drugs.
Why don't you ask that question? You just wasted your... It's probably an awesome counter or bathtub crank. Come on, get up.
We don't want Randy's, you know?
I don't know. I don't want to make fun of people named Randy and being trashy, because I'm clearly trashy myself. And I got to tell you, man, my life is looking up, because on Christmas, I accidentally bought myself a crossbow. And everybody says, accidentally? Yes, actually, accidentally. My buddy's wife wanted to buy her dude a crossbow, and so I bought an extra one for $13. And then she didn't message me back, and I was like, God damn, I guess I got a crossbow. So no, I have a crossbow. And you might wonder, do you hunt? But no, I don't. No way, I don't hunt. I just own a crossbow, and thanks to a garbage fire ex-girlfriend of mine that went to beauty school, I also own a duffel bag full of mannequin heads. And a bunch of terrified neighbors. True story, on New Year's, me and Hunter were getting whiskey drunk outside, shooting mannequin heads with crossbow bolts. You know, like you did. And one of my neighbors came out to smoke a cigarette while I'm shooting crossbow bolts into a fake head, screaming, "Look at me, I'm Daryl!" And, like he was probably really good for crossbow sales. What do you think? Anyway, he was like, "Man, I think you're scaring your neighbor." I was like, "No, I got this." And I picked up a crossbow, like a mannequin head, like Medusa, like with a crossbow bolt sticking out of the eye. And I looked at my neighbor and I was like, "It's cool, ex-girlfriends." He didn't hear all that backstory I just told y'all. In my head, it was apostrophe S, and that's possessive. What he heard was plural. And he put his cigarette out and went back inside. So I think I'm going to have a talk with my landlady very soon. That'll be weird. You guys are awesome. Give up for the troops, everybody. Mostly them little African child soldiers, man. They're really putting in the work. Kids kill the darndest things, man. I was just thinking about that last night. I thought that was real funny. So was Johnny Depp and Steven Tyler like a looper kind of situation? Or is that just where we as a nation have decided to keep a repository of scars and rings in case of a fire? Alright, that's just the best joke ever. Whiskey gun tour, turns out. Oh, side note, so you guys know, the reason we call it Whiskey Gun Tour is because one night on my birthday, we did a show, and I decided to buy this water gun at the gas station across the street from my house. And it was like a water gun that had a little cylinder full of bubble gum. And I was like, man, I'm going to buy one of those and fill it with early times. Because my parents had drinks for me, and I decided they should. So I just showed up at a show and started squirting people in the face with whiskey. not a very nice thing to do. Don't do that. Turns out you can't aim for the uvula. That will take them down. You get a side cheek with it, but what happened too is there was like this cylinder of bubble gum in the top part that has nothing to do with the water gun. It was very superfluous. I don't know why they did it. But through a serious flaw in design, what happens is what would normally be water but was whiskey would get into the bubble gum, which would then flavor said early times. Y'all ain't had anything, so you had bubble gum said early times. So I don't drink whiskey anymore. Mostly. It gets dodgy. I start playing Megatouch like a motherfucker. I'm on point, man. I can tell when a nipple's missing, all kinds of shit. Any robot's a sex robot if you got the gumption, you know what I mean? You might have to chase a robot around for a second. Just put a toe on it. Ain't going nowhere. See what happens. You are my mechanical dreams. Let's make a Philip K. Dick novel happen. So I drink a lot. I bet Janis Joplin smelled like a foot. What do you guys think? She just looked like it. No? She looks like the human equivalent of a macrame plant hanger. Come on, man.
Hey, my name is Janis.
Is it Joplin? Let's take it down a notch. Fuck in the bathroom. What's your name? I hurt your feelings. No, I like classic rock. I hate the Doors.
Yeah! Oh, is that where we're at? Oh, watch it! Okay, watch it. Round of applause. Who loves the Doors? Oh, this was a strong crowd for the Doors. Watch this. You're gonna stand behind this? Are we sure? Round of applause. Who loves the Doors? All right, I'm gonna throw out some lyrics to you, and let's test your fucking love. Carry me across the sea where milky babies seem to be.
Yeah.
Every night at the quarter moon, there'll be a monsoon in your lagoon. At night they fly, you better run. These winged things are not much fun. Yeah? You're behind all this? You sure?
It's still better than you.
Because two of those are from Jumanji. And you don't know which two. Gods.
I did have awesome parents, man. Give it up for people who had awesome parents. Give it up.
That might get other people to feel real weird.
Karen was kind of a shitter. Awesome parents, man. They were cool, man. Growing up, my parents had a pull-out bed. But they also had me and my brother, so they must have had a dumb pull-out bed. Come on, her tits ottoman. I'm not proud of it. Cool. I don't want to be famous doing this, clearly. I'm not trying to be famous. I just want to be like, own a monkey famous. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know if you ever got people that own monkeys in Pittsburgh. We definitely got them in Knoxville. We know all three of them. Own a monkey famous. That's a special kind of famous. Like, look at that. Look at that dude with that monkey on his shoulder. One of them works construction in the mall. That's how famous Own a Monkey Famous is. I know his job and not his name. Own a Monkey Famous, man. I don't know what you got. Like, we should all follow our dreams, you know what I mean? Like, that's what you're supposed to do. And dreams should be free, and I get that. But I know exactly the cost of my dreams. Because it turns out, first of all, good monkey, $3,000 to $5,000. No, but for real. I haven't price checked that shit. A decent monkey is $3,000 to $5,000. You can get some shit monkey for like $1,200. I don't know where you do that. You want some Etsy monkey, you be my guest. That's the monkey that claws her eyes out while you're asleep. Doesn't matter what you name it. Don't get some fucking $1,200 monkey, you get a high performance $3,000 to $5,000 monkey. Right? Get a decent monkey, $3,000 to $5,000. Right? I know how much my dreams cost. $3,000 to $5,000. For a decent monkey, and then you chuck in $2,000 for the matching outfits, right? You're gonna go to the monkey and not dress it like you. You're not gonna get a Bandino outfit for that monkey. I don't know who the fuck you think you are. You don't deserve to own a $3,000 to $5,000 monkey. If you're not gonna put it in a fucking Young Guns outfit, that's on you. You dress it like Chavez E. Chavez and go on your way. That was for the poor people that saw Young Guns. So what's that? $3,000 to $5,000, another two, so we'll say $7,000. And then you throw in that $15,000 for the hang glider, right? You guys can't imagine the dream that I have. Hang gliding when a monkey's strapped to you, dressed like you. The best shit ever. And you throwing that crossbow. Me flying through the skies like Falcor and never in its story. You give me a cross look, I'm gonna take your fucking eye out. And the monkey's gonna cheer me on. I don't know if you've done the math, that's gonna cost about $50,000. I'm not gonna bet. That's how dreams work, man. You guys are fucking awesome, by the way. Give it up for everybody in the room, man. I'm never not happy about coming to Pittsburgh, man. I fucking love this town, man. I love this town so much. I love this theater, actually. Every time I come here, I play this theater. It's super fucking fun, man. You guys should be happy that you have this in your town. I live in Knoxville. We ain't got shit. Be happy, man. Give it up for Nipples. Nipples are fucking awesome, aren't they?
Nipples.
As long as they're attached to something. You know? Take anything away from the show tonight, don't pick up street nipples. You know what I mean?
But real quick, PSA, before you guys get out of here, because I know how much you guys are drinking. Most of it is for dudes, to be fair. I'm sure it crosses over to the ladies and some of you guys. You guys make sure you're drinking and you're having fun. Do not send a pic of your dick to your ex-girlfriend. I'll agree to not do that.
I'll agree not to do that.
I
did that 2 weeks ago. I don't know where I found stamps that late. But in like 3 or 4 days, man, that girl's gonna be pissed. That's how they did it back in the olden days. You know that, right? You'd be hanging out on your plantation and there'd be some little sweaty dude run up a dusty road with a letter. And you'd give him lemonade. That was like currency then. It was like their Bitcoin. Sweet. You open a letter and be like, "Dearest Victoria, I hope the crops are growing well. Virginia lime is hard, and closed is a tin tap of my penis. Love always, Randy." P.S. This war is fucking bullshit, dude. You guys, thanks for being my friend.